Hi, I'm Sanjay Nagchowdhury, Development Lead for the IBM App Connect Enterprise product. In this video, I will demonstrate how to invoke a REST API using IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12. I'll be using the REST API that I deployed in my previous video, so please watch that video first if you would like to see how to develop a REST API. So you can now invoke a REST API using an OpenAPI version 2 and OpenAPI version 3 document in IBM App Connect Enterprise. I'm going to invoke a REST API using the REST request node. So the backend REST API is defined using an OpenAPI version 3 document. And I'm going to use a REST request node to invoke it. And that REST request node will be configured from the same OpenAPI version 3 document. So this is the REST API that I'm going to invoke, and I'm going to send a request to this get operation to get a pet by ID. So first of all, I'm going to create a new application. And in that application, I'm going to create a message flow. And in this message flow, I'm going to add a REST request node, which will invoke the REST API. So I'm going to open the REST draw and select the REST request node. The REST request node can be configured from an OpenAPI document, and I'm going to select the OpenAPI document that is being used by the REST API, and I'm going to retrieve it using HTTP. So I need to provide the URL to the OpenAPI document. So to get the URL of the OpenAPI document, I've opened the web UI for the test server where the REST API is deployed. I'm going to click on the REST API. And if I click on properties, I can see the link to the OpenAPI document. So I'll copy this URL. And I'm going to paste it here. So I can now see the operations that are defined in the REST API, and I'm going to select the get pet by ID operation. So this REST request node is now configured to use the same OpenAPI document. It is based on OpenAPI version 3, and it is configured to invoke the get pet by ID operation. So I'm going to invoke this flow using HTTP. So I'll add an HTTP input node and an HTTP reply node. And I'll add a URL. And I'm going to send a JSON message to this flow. So I'll specify JSON domain, and I'll set error handling to use JSON. So the JSON message that I'm going to send into this flow will contain the pet ID, and that pet ID needs to be sent as a path parameter by the REST request node to the backend API. The REST API also requires an API key. If we look at the OpenAPI document, which can be viewed using the OpenAPI editor, which is new in IBM App Connect Enterprise version 12, we can see that for the get operation, one of the security requirements is to provide an API key in the HTTP header. So that needs to be set in the REST request that is sent out. To do that, I'll need to set it in the local environment. So in this example, I'm going to require each client request to provide the API key for the REST request node to use in the request that is sent to the backend REST API. Alternatively, in App Connect Enterprise version 12, you can use a secured credentials vault. So you can store the service identity, such as the API key, in the credentials vault. The identity can then be used by the REST request node by configuring the node. You would specify a security identity which maps back to the credential, and that can be then used by the REST request node on each invocation. So I'm going to use a mapping node to map the JSON message input tree so that I can then extract the API key and the ID and map it to the output tree. So in order to do that, I'll need to use a JSON schema so that the mapping node can use it. So I will import the JSON schema. I can simply drag and drop it onto my application. So this is the JSON schema here. And if I open it, you can see that the JSON message will contain an ID, which is an integer, and an API key, which is a string. So now I can use a mapping node to map the fields. And I need to set the API key in the local environment as an override in the output tree from the mapping node so that the REST request node can use it. So I'm going to add the local environment tree so that I can map it. So the API key will need to be set under destination REST request API key. So I'm going to simply wire the API key to the from the input tree to the API key in the local environment. I'm also going to copy the ID to the output tree as well. And that ID will be used in the REST request node to send as a path parameter. So I've configured my map. And now in my REST request node, I need to specify the pet ID as a path parameter. And to do that, I will specify an XPath expression to extract the ID from the message body. So it will be in a property called ID. I can click Finish. So the REST request node is now configured. And I can now simply wire up the terminals between the nodes. And I'm going to add an extra HTTP reply node to deal with error situations. So the client flow has now been created and I can deploy the flow. So I will deploy it using the flow exerciser. So I can view the message as it is processed by the flow. So I'm going to send a message using curl to this client flow, and I will be able to see the message through the flow exerciser. So here I have specified an ID and I've specified an invalid value for the API key, and it has returned 401, and I can see the error reason code. And if I click on View Path, I can see the request that came in. So it had ID 123. And I can see that in the local environment override, the API key was specified. And I can see that the response back from the backend was that the API key that was provided was invalid. And I can see that a 401 was returned. If I now specify the request with a valid API key, I can see that 200 status code was returned and the pet details were returned, where I can see the name and the ID that was specified. If I click on View Path, I can see the ID that was specified and I can see the API key, and I can see it came out of the out terminal from the REST request node, and I can see that the backend REST API returned 200 and the pet details were returned. So in this video, I've demonstrated how to invoke a REST API using IBM AppConnect Enterprise version 12. I used a REST request node to send the request message and receive the response message. The REST request node was configured using an OpenAPI version 3 document. As an alternative, the REST async request and REST async response nodes can also be used so that requests and responses are handled asynchronously.